Clap your hands for yourselves. Clap your hands for yourselves. I want to see how much more are you going to clap. Do you clap for yourself more than you clap for your father? Clap for yourself, let me see. Now let's clap hands for our servant tonight. The servant of God that is in our midst. Bishop Mthondo, Charles Mthondo. He is a man of God. Can we clap hands? You can do better than that. You can do better than that. You can do better than that. Clap your hands for the servant of the Lord. Child of God, clap those hands. Hey! Raboshaka baba baba baba. In the name of Jesus. Right now, I want us to pray. Just, okay, welcome you, man of God. The man of God that is in our midst tonight is a great servant of God. Most of us, we know him from Maitland. He was with us for some days. And we have a couple in this house, which he wedded himself. Those people, they know themselves, they are amongst our midst right now. He wedded them. So he is a servant of God. So Apostle Joshua doesn't call anyone. You know, our father is he is full of wisdom. He can never just call any man. Whenever he calls a man of God, just know that man of God is a servant that is greatly used, that is mightily used. Bishop Charles Mthondo is a man of God that is used tremendously by God in our lives. The time he was with us in Maitland, whoa, those who were there before, whoever that was there, can you please show with your hands, raise up your hand. Yes. I test in the name of Jesus. I had great testimonies after he was in Maitland. Hey, when he left, I'm telling you, I didn't, because I'm not on Facebook, otherwise you would have seen my testimonies. I was the first to testify. The reason why I testified is that I opened my heart because he's a servant of God. And I said, because I trust Apostle Joshua, he never called anyone who's just coming to make chaka chaka here. He always calls men of God that he trusts, that he knows, because our father in the house is the father of wisdom. So surely tonight, if you open your heart, men of God will minister to you and you will get your portion. Who can remind me the program of tonight? What is the name of this program? Again? So, I want my portion. You know what? If you don't open your own heart, myself, just as I hand over, I'll sit down and open my own heart. Because I want to have to get to go back home with my own portion. So, if you want your portion tonight, you have to open that heart. For the Bible says, see, I've sent a man after my heart to be your pastors, to be your prophets. You must believe in them. So if you are here and you are not believing in the word that he's going to give unto us, just know that the word that he's coming with is a word of God, is a word in season that God himself wants to minister unto your life. So before he comes over, I want us to pray one prayer point. Father, anything that is within me, that is around me, that will cause me not to understand, that will cause me not to accept, that will cause me not to believe the word of God that will come out of this altar tonight. Father God, I command that power, that spirit to bow in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, at the mention of the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, all other powers will bow. Even that power that the devil tonight wants to use in your own heart so that you mustn't believe. He only wants you to go back the same way. But that is not the will of God. The will of God is that you get your portion tonight. And you must always respect the last moment miracle. This is what is going to happen in this house. That deliverance that you are looking for, that breakthrough that you are looking for, it lies to your own heart. Our God doesn't look at what you are wearing. Our God doesn't look at how much you have. He looks unto your own heart. That your own heart, if it's open wide for that word of God to enter. That word will enter and do something. And therefore, you will go home with your portion tonight. You will go home with your portion. Therefore, pray with me. Father, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus and the blood of Jesus, Father, every power that has vowed to minister to me wrongly, lying spirit into my life, that I must not listen to your word. As you send your servant tonight, I command that spirit, that power, die tonight, be scattered. Yeah, in the name of Jesus, amen. Let's pray upon. Father, speak to me tonight through your servant. Let the word in season that you have given unto your servant, let it change my life. Father, do something new in my life. Begin to pray, child of God. Speak to me, oh God. Open that heart and tell God to speak to you. Let's pray. Father, speak to me tonight. Father, do something new in my life tonight. Father, do not allow me to live here the same way I came. Father God, speak to me through your servant, mighty God. Let your word do something new in my life. Let your word do something new in my life. Father God, minister unto me. Let my deliverance come to pass. Let my breakthrough come to pass through your word that will come out of this altar tonight. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. As we have prayed, so shall it be. Right now, as we have prayed, you will receive what you want. Just believe. Just open your heart. In the name of Jesus. God is here tonight. So as I hand over to the man of God, can we all clap our hands? I want the noise. I want to hear that noise. I want to hear that noise. Hey!
Lift up your eyes in the presence of God and close your eyes and begin to contemplate the presence of God. Begin right now to welcome the Spirit of God in the way that you always speak, because God is present and God is here. Right now, I feel the atmosphere of God. Glory to Jesus. 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 The power of God is available right now to change your life. Speak to God and tell God to visit you right this minute. Begin to speak to God. Tell God to visit you. Begin to tell God to visit you. Thank you, Jesus. Begin to tell God to visit you right now. Come on, pray. Wanna say, Baba, oh, oh, say, I just wanna say, Baba, oh, oh, Lift up your voice and begin to say that.
I just wanna see. Is the night of war. Tonight is the night of battle. You're about to take over. You are not only going to take over. After you take over, you are about to walk over. Hallelujah. It's been a long time that the enemy has been messing up with you. But tonight is a decision. It's either you or the enemy. But one thing that I know, you are leaving this place as a winner. I say you are leaving this place as an overcomer. The louder your amen, receive yours now. Listen, something wonderful is going to happen to you. Before I come here, I come for a meeting. You can hear my voice. And the Lord has tremendously blessed people. You see, as I'm here, I'm feeling in the realm of the Spirit that there is something that devil has been doing in your life, in your family. That process is about to be canceled right now. We serve a mighty God. We come here by the divine mandate of God. And if God allow me to be here, that means there is something that God wants to do to your life. The only thing I want you to do is to be focused. Say to your neighbor, be focused. Say to your neighbor, be focused. Father, I thank you for this minute. I pray that you take over right this minute so that we can take over together with you. We want to walk over and we want to take what belongs to us. You promised that tonight you are going to give us our portion, and we are here for our portion. Father, before, oh God, this portion become natural, I take it from supernatural right now. Whatever the answer for your children are, right now, I begin to take it in the mighty name of Jesus. When I'm speaking the word, let it be given to each and every one of them in this place in the name of Jesus. By the time we finish this service, Lord, may your children leave this place filled with miracle, filled with the grace, filled with the testimony, filled with the blessing. If you believe yours is coming on your way, shout three times, amen. 1, 2, 3.
Thank you very much for the praise and worship. God bless you. You can have your seat. You can have your seat. Yes, you guys with your sound, you can stay there because any moment you know me, I can fly. Hallelujah. I can fly. Can you just take your juice majestically? Because I'm already having the Holy Ghost juice right now. Hallelujah. Thank you very much, my waiter. Amen. Yeah, take everything out because we are going to scatter everything. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of you come here prepared? How many of you come here prepared? Yeah, because I know some people, you just come because you hear someone say, okay, let us go. Yeah, because some people, you just come because, okay, let us go. Okay, just come. Follow. You just follow. Let us go. But some people, they come because they said, I'm coming because I need a solution tonight. Huh? What is this night normally called? Solution. Hey. So if you are not coming here for a solution, that means you are coming here for what? Wasting time, isn't it? It's simple. Hallelujah. You are not coming for a solution. What are you coming for? Resolution or revolution? Hallelujah. Something must happen in your life. Every day is not the same. And every night is not the same. Hallelujah. In advance, I prophesy that this night is yours. Now, one thing that I'm asking you to do today, I want you to, for a little bit time, let me make you a mad person. So for now, become mad. After the program, the healing is already there. After the program, you are normal. So that whatever you're going to do, people, they will not going to judge you based on what they see you do. They will just know that you are mad. If you are screaming, they know that you are mad, so they don't bother you. Hallelujah. Because if they see you are doing certain things, they will think like you are crazy. Instead of them think you are crazy, let them know that you are already crazy. Because when you are coming to the presence of God, bossy, and you are making a mistake, because God is a boss. You see, in the presence of God, we got only three particular positions. In the heaven, there are only three positions. In heaven, there are no much position. There are only three positions. The first position is the position of what we call praise. Say praise. And the second position is what we call worship. Say worship. And then the third position is sitting. That means receiving. Hallelujah. So in the presence of God, the three positions. And the first position is the position of a praise. Someone who is giving praise. Either he has to stand up or lay down. Hallelujah. Now, someone, the second position is the people who are kneeling down. Hallelujah. In the heaven, there are only two positions that is activated or is busy. And is one position that is never been busy but is doing only one thing, receiving. God is always sitting in his throne. That is the first position of God, and nobody can change that. And the two positions that left is the position that belongs to the angel, the archangels, and every living being that are in heaven. One side they are doing praise, and another one they are doing what? Worship. And God on the third position is doing what? Receiving. Are you following me? In the heaven, there's no opposition. Hallelujah. So if you are coming here to stand up, be careful, because you are going to get a spiritual slap. Hallelujah. Yes, I'm warning you. So you need to come here and believe that you are coming to the presence of God. You are not boss. You are ready to receive from the Almighty God. And when you come to the presence of God,
You need to do what? To squeeze yourself, make yourself little, and give him all the glory. Amen. Regardless of what you do, if you are manager or whatsoever, manager or whatever, call yourself name you want to call it. But here, make yourself that you're managing whatever, toilet manage, kitchen manage, whatsoever. It doesn't make any sense in the presence of God. Hallelujah. So you humble yourself before God. There's no bishop, there's no apostle, there's no prophet. All of us in the presence of God, we have to bow in praise and worship. Understand me? That's the moment now you are going to attract the presence of God to release and give to you what you are looking for. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I see God already opening doors before I start preaching. Amen. Listen for me. Listen for me. I'm hearing from the Spirit. God is saying to me, there are 16 people who are going already to testify on Sunday. Not next week, but on Sunday. Listen for me. You see, this is what we call sudden and quick miracle. You are going to see what I'm talking to you. Because we see, we don't serve that God who is coming next year. No. That we don't serve that God that's coming within 6 months, no. We serve that God that we say, the God of now. Hallelujah.
Say, my Father, my Father. My Father, my Father. Locate my story now. Locate my story now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Say, oh Lord. Say, oh Lord. May my name be known in your plans. In Jesus' name. Amen.
We cannot do anything or cannot proceed without, remember I said we are crazy, without making a crazy noise. Even though you are sitting, if you want to jump, without making a crazy noise, since we are already worshiping God, we need to worship the God of this house. Make a crazy noise. If you are going to jump, whatever you're going to do, make me feel that you are welcoming me to preach freely. Acknowledge you, the man of God, whatever he is, Apostle Joshua Simeon, by your clapping, by your willing, whatsoever he's going to put. Do that so that my spirit be rested. Come on now. Appreciate the man of God. Place, your sickness is leaving you today. It doesn't matter the name of the sickness you have. I wish there will be an hospital opening tomorrow that you can run tomorrow. In fact, even though they don't receive you, they'll receive you by favor. You are going to do the test. Even though they don't do test tomorrow I open that laboratory, they'll make a test in the name of Jesus. When you are running here on Sunday, you are running with your testimony. Natural. I want you to read Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1 to 3. Ecclesiastes chapter 3. Start from verse 1. Let us read the word of God with a loud voice. It's already on the screen. The first one I say, scroll down, you scroll down. 1 to 3. Did I read that for the word of God? 1 to 3. Scroll down. Scroll down. Let's scroll down.
I prophesy over your life. I say from tonight, the time of weeping in your life is over. I prophesy over your life. The time of crying is end tonight. I prophesy over your life. What was making you to mourn, right this morning, you are going to laugh after them in the name of Jesus Christ. I prophesy over your life. The time to dance is now. There are some people who have done years, they never laugh. I said to you, what is going to happen to you? Even though you did not want to laugh, but what is going to happen to you? It will arrest everything in you. Before you know it, you'll begin to laugh. Before you know it, you'll begin to laugh. Receive the joy. Sit down. There is a time for everything under the sun. But God, why? If there is a time to laugh, why me, I am not laughing? But God, why? If there is a time for celebration, why I am not celebrating? But God, why? If there is a time to dance, why I am not dancing? Others are dancing, but I am not dancing. Who is that one who is stopping me to dance? Who is that one who is causing me to cry? Who is that one who is after my job? God, who is that person? If God say there are time for everything, but the everything that I see, it seems to be only bad on my side. I'm not seeing the good part of the everything. The everything that I'm seeing, it is only the mourn side. It is only the disappointment side. It's only the rejection side. But what about the laughing and dancing time? What have I done to deserve what I'm seeing? Hallelujah. Say, God, am I not in your plan? Because this is the plan of God. He said, the plan that I have for you is not for you to be harmed. It's not to harm you, but it's for a blessing. Hallelujah. It's to give you a blessing, an expected end. But how come I'm always crying? Listen for me. I was saying, I think last time I was here, I was saying this. Whenever you are crying, someone somewhere is laughing. I was saying, whenever you are crying, someone somewhere is laughing. Whenever you are complaining, someone somewhere is rejoicing. Whenever you are sick, someone somewhere is gymnastic, is enjoying with a good health. Whosoever is enjoying what belongs to you, let them catch fire now. Listen for me. Listen for me. This world that we are, it is not the world, it is not the world of just the way you see it. I was saying last time, I said, Paul said,
fight a good fight of faith. So in another way, this world as you are seeing is a world of fight. As long as that you are living, fight you never cease. That is why Jesus said in John chapter 17, he said, Father, I am going, but I leave those one you give me into this world. I know that the enemy is attacking them. Though they are in this world, but they are not belong to this world. But as long as that they are in this world, I pray that you watch over them. If Jesus said that, he knows what is going to happen to us. So that's why John came. And the Bible says, since the time of the John baptized, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and violence take it by I say today, whether the devil lacks it or not, we are taking it by fire, by force. Listen for me. Let no one tell you lie. Let no one tell you theologian, say strategy or whatsoever. I come to tell you the truth, and that is the whole truth. God will not come from heaven to come and give you what you want. You have to make a step. You have to make a decision and begin to pursue what belongs to you. Hallelujah. It is your responsibility to stand and say, enough is enough. I can no longer continue in this life. I need a change in my life. Hallelujah. Now, listen to me. There is a time for everything. Jesus Christ, listen for me. According to the way God has created us, there is what we call there's what we call natural destiny. Amen. Now, what was happening in our life, if all of us, we are here. How do we come in life? Who give birth to us? Our mothers, isn't it? So, all of us here, we come through a woman. Amen? We come through what? A woman. So, if you come through a woman, so we are all born by a woman. So, destiny, according to the structure of God, all of us here, by destiny, naturally, we come from what? A woman. There is nobody under the sun who was born by a tree. It's not there. Naturally, all of us, we have to born from what? A woman. Hallelujah. All of us, we have to come by a woman. Hallelujah. And nobody can change that. That is a destiny set by God. Hallelujah. It's a destiny. And that is the way it's supposed to be. According to God, naturally, you were born South African. You cannot change that. You are born what? And naturally, God wanted you to be born South African. God wanted you to be born Nigerian. God wanted you to be born Congolese. God wanted you to be born Zimbabwean, Mozambican, Malawians. Name it. So it is not by man's sight. Hallelujah. It is not your mother and your father who discuss to say, when we get our children, we want my children to be all short. Now, it is naturally, all right, I'm just teaching you, I'm coming. Hallelujah. Yeah, you must know me by now. Yeah, you must know me by now. So, naturally, you are short because that is your destiny. Naturally, you are dark, that is your destiny. You are light and complexion, that is the destiny. You are destined to be born in the dark family. You are destined to be born in white family. Naturally, that's the way it was planned. Hallelujah. You cannot negotiate which family you want to become. Some of you are even praying, say, God, can you restart creating me so that I'll choose where to come? Hallelujah. But naturally, you cannot change that. So there are things that naturally you came this way. Amen. Hallelujah. A tree is a tree. It's just there. An animal is an animal. It's just there. Amen. I'm going somewhere. I'm going to provoke your spirit in a few minutes. And it's going to allow you to pray severe. And you are going to be very angry for what was happening to you. Hallelujah. Now, that is a destiny that is naturally the way God wanted it to be. Amen? Now, that is the way God has planned it. Located Africa, Europe, Asia, America, and so forth. Amen? Now, you can't change it, and you cannot begin to complain to God because things are not working for you. Say, all right, I wanted to be born this way so that things will work for me. No. God knows why it was meant so. Amen. That is why it is very important to be proud of who we are. It doesn't matter about my color, but one thing that I know, it is not my fault to be maybe half and half the way I am. I look like white and black, so it doesn't matter. But I know one thing, that God wanted me to be this way. I look like I'm coming from nowhere because I'm black, but God wanted me to be a black man. That's the truth, sir. So you need to enjoy that. You need to enjoy that. As long as that you not enjoy that, I'm telling you, it's getting bad for you. It's gonna get bad. It's gonna get bad. You need to enjoy that. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor. Ask your neighbor. Do you like yourself? Oh yes. Hallelujah. I'm happy to be who I am. Regardless of the way you are looking at me, I like my size, you see. I can jump, you see. I don't want to be you, I want to be me, you see, because maybe you can't run, but I can still run, you see what I mean. So I like the way I am for now. Hallelujah. Now I want you to put me another verse there on the screen, which we're gonna read in a minute. I want you to put me Job chapter 1. Thank you, Jesus. Now, alternatively, start from, read for me first, Luke chapter 1, verse 18. Can you put that? Luke chapter 1, verse 18 to 38. We're going to be okay. Right, now. And can we read that? 1, 2, 3. And Zechariah said unto the angel, whereby shall I know this? For I am an old man. Continue. Right, just jump the very same chapter, just jump from verse 36 and 37, 38, we'll stop there. 36, right? Say that again. Say that again. Speak it with confidence. Now speak it next to the person that you are saying.
God said, for with God, nothing is impossible. Now, in the name of Jesus, nothing is impossible.
Even though they said, oh, this is the prophetic now. Even though they say that you are not going to get that tender, but I speak right now that you are receiving it in the name of Jesus. I don't know why this comes. That means it's for someone. Now listen to this. See this. Mary, he was the wife of Joseph. And the Bible said to me that the angel of God appeared to her and said to her that the Lord has chosen you among the women. Amen. You are highly favored. Oh, he said you are highly what? Favored. And see what is happening. And now God said he's going to bless you, giving you a son, and that will be a king. And no, forget about Zachariah first. We are already jumping to I prophesy so that you speedily come to the spirit, because you are now, oh my God, you're already back. Right. Now he said, I'm going to make you a great mother known into the whole nation. Now Mary was not understanding what he was saying to him, to her. Said, how can you tell me I'm going to have a child when I am not sleeping with any man? Hallelujah. Now, Mary was seeing, or he was looking into the culture that he was before her. Hallelujah. He was looking the culture. Joseph to Mary, he was like a tradition, the law and the culture. Why? The law says men and women, they are going to sleep together, and from there they will do what? Have a child. Amen. And culture said you cannot have this woman if you have not given. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the law and tradition of the Jews said that you cannot marry a woman if it's not a virgin. Hallelujah. Look at some people are looking at me when I say virgin. You need to understand that every woman under the sun is a virgin. Maybe you got the wrong conception about virginity, but I don't want to talk about that now, because I'm going to go deep and I'm going to confuse you. But every woman under the sun is a virgin. Now, see this. Now, Mary was confused. Amen. Mary was what? Now, the confusion was, how can this be? I'm a virgin. There is a law. Joseph and me, we are not finished things yet. And also, I have not slept with her. You know, I can't sleep with her. It's just God forbid. How can you do that? Now, it was this. And this is what we call supernatural destiny. Now, you see, there are some of you here, you never been in school. And you are just wondering. You just look at yourself and you look at your size. You look at your background. There's no way that you can think that you can be one day in the parliament. Why? Because you see yourself the way you are, you never study, you see yourself that there's nothing that shows that you can even think of being in a parliament. But supernaturally, you can find yourself in the parliament. You see, some of you look at yourself according to what the doctor says, and they say that, all right, we tested you and look at your womb the way it's looking, you cannot have a child. And you look at how does the record and the statistic of the doctor come and say to you, you say, oh, of course, that's true, because they remove my womb. So I cannot have a child again. But supernaturally, you know, when supernatural comes, it breaks the law. And when the supernatural comes, it breaks the traditional. When the supernatural comes, he broke the culture. I prophesy over you, whatever was standing as the law is breaking now. Supernaturally, you are about to receive it. Listen for me. There are things that you were struggling to do because you are not qualified to do so. Hallelujah. You see yourself the way you are, you said, all right, which kind of man is going to like me since the robe has been removed? Hallelujah. 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 You find yourself with this kind of sickness, and you know that when you talk about HIV, people say, oh. But you don't know what is going to happen to you. But when supernatural comes, it changes everything. If the Lord said you are not allowed to marry, even though it is your gogo, or your mama, or your papa, or your uncle, they say you are not going to get married. Of course, you have seen that many of your family, because they have declared like that to them and nothing has happened to them. But they forget that you are depending into the supernatural power of God. Mary, she was a virgin. And she was not allowed to have a child. Hallelujah. But supernaturally God located her. Hallelujah. Supernaturally God located her. Now as you are here, some of you have tenders, or you have an applications, or you have job, or whatsoever you have already approved there. But they are not even putting eyes on that because you are not fit in any way. But one thing that is going to happen right now is I'm speaking, supernaturally,
God is going to send an angel.
Anybody to speak for you to get that job. You don't have anybody to speak to you, for that man to come to you. But I want to speak to you. The angel asked and answered Mary. He said, I am Gabriel. May angel Gabriel appear to your guest tonight.
Send an angel tonight who is going to step up in your situation. The Lord is going to change the situation. He's going to make what is impossible to become possible. If you believe, shout and receive.
Sitting here and the doctor say your problem is close, because with the kind of diagnosis that we have seen, and you are having only 32 days to live, or 3 months to live, or 4 months to live, because we cannot do anything at your situation anymore. But as I'm speaking right now, I can hear the angel of God is saying to me, tell them, supernaturally, I'm about to appear into their cases. The word of that doctor, the word of that person say that you are not going to make it right this minute is about to be disappointed in the name of Jesus Christ.
Some are saying that because this baby is born,
with a lot of complication. He's not supposed to live because this baby has to die. And they're even asking you, say, if there's any possibility, you can just sign a paper so that you don't make the baby suffer. Why don't you sign a paper to kill the baby? But I come to say to you, you don't need to sign a dead warrant, because otherwise, if you do so, you are the son of Lucifer. Better still, you are Lucifer yourself. But I come to tell you, there is a new warrant that is released from heaven right now. There is a new order that has been released from heaven. I prophesy, if it's your sister, your brother, your auntie, whosoever is a member of your family, that they declare that the baby is going to die because of the condition that is born. I, as a man of God, I prophesy, they shall live in the name of Jesus Christ. They shall live in the name of Jesus Christ. Supernaturally, something is going to happen to them. Lift up your right hands. Anybody in your family who right now is battling with death, now, this minute, this is the inspiration of me. I'm feeling it up. Anybody in your family who is battling with death right now, as I'm speaking as a man of God, anybody in your family who is in the coma right now, as I'm speaking as a man of God, someone in your family that they say they want to cut his leg, they say they want to cut his hands, they say they are about to take something in his tummy, as I'm speaking as a man of God, whatever they are trying to do to her or to him, every process they are about to processing, wherever they are looking to take what belongs to you, whether it's a house or it's whatsoever, I declare as a man of God, that procedure is canceled in the name of Jesus. It's canceled in the name of Jesus. I declare life. I declare life. I declare deliverance. I grant healing in the name of Jesus. Listen, I want you to pray. Take it serious. You see, because this situation I'm talking about, there are a lot of people who are in it, where you don't understand, you don't know what to do. You see, your situation right now is you are here. Some of you said, I don't know how I'm going to start. My situation needs divine intervention because I'm struggling. I don't know how it's going to happen. I want to stand. No, 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 sit down. Stand up. I want you to pray at least for 5 minutes, because there is a supernatural destiny where God can send his angel. When the angel of God appears, your situation will have another solution. You are going to pray. Say, my father, my father, my father, my father, my father, my father, look unto my situation right now. Right now, send your angel. Send your angel on my behalf. On my behalf. Say, oh Lord. Oh Lord. Oh Lord. Send an angel in my family, in my business, in my health. Right now. 1, 2, 3, prayer, 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 prayer. Prayer, 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 prayer. Ask God, pray, pray, pray. Ra, prayer, prayer, prayer. Pray to God, pray, pray, pray. Pray, 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 pray. Pray, pray, pray. Prayer, 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 prayer.
Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray.
Sit down. Sit down. We are here to deal with evil. I said tonight you are leaving this place overcome. Now we are reading the book of Job, chapter 1. Something is going to happen tonight. Wait, you see. Job chapter 1 and verse 1 to 18. And prepare again with me Genesis chapter 27. No, so Genesis chapter 18. Now go to Job chapter 1. Is that there? Okay, John. I did not say John, say Job. Job, yes. Not John, Job. Job chapter 1. Yes, can we read that? 1, 2, 3. Scroll down. Scroll down. Now, just jump to verse. So far we are in 5, yeah? Just jump to verse 16 so that we don't be like, we don't take time. But I did it. Hold on. We already gone far a little bit. Go back, maybe on verse 10. Because what I want you to hear is not there. Can you go back? Verse 10. Yes. Yes. Go ahead. Read. Scroll down.
Amen.
Now this. While you are sitting here, someone is negotiating for you to die. While you are sitting here, someone is negotiating to get your marriage. While you are sitting here, someone is claiming your kidney. While you are sitting here, someone is looking for your child. That is what we call negotiable destiny. So your destiny has been actually negotiated into the realm of the spirit. That's why you find out that every time you want to do things, it's difficult, even though you try to penetrate. You see, by the time you're about to get it, it's just vanished. Some of you, you find out that you are in a marriage and the man beats you every day. He kicks you out and you come. It's not like you are not just like you are doing practice of marathon. You run this side and you come back. You run and you come back. So you find out that you are negotiating. Your life has been negotiated. So you don't have a peace. You don't sit and enjoy your marriage. So you go today and tomorrow, next time you come, you go and you come. Hallelujah. You see, you find out that there are some people that they, you see that if you see someone in the coma, some people they go to coma 3 days, they are out. 30 days is too much. You find out that there are people in the coma, they are in the coma, the doctors, they are saying, oh, this guy cannot live. Yeah, why don't you just kill him and finish him? Some are saying, no, you cannot live. I believe my brother will come alive. You see, while you are there, people are negotiating for your destiny. I say, as you are sitting here, nobody from hell will be able to negotiate your death in the name of Jesus. I say, nobody, even though it's Lucifer himself, he will not be able to negotiate your head in the name of Jesus. Job, he was ignorant, enjoying his life. Someone somewhere was looking for him to die. He did not even know what was happening. But yet the enemy, devil, Satan, Lucifer, he was talking to God. He said, I need this woman to die. Ah, you see, you guys, you take the things for granted. That's why when we say to pray, you think like we are making exercises. No, we are telling you because you are here, but people are negotiating. Do you know how many people they get jealous the day you say I do? Some people, the moment they ask you that question, will you? He start now praying. He said, God, instead of him or her say, I do. He said, let her twist that word, say, I reject you. So that the man will leave her and start looking on me. Do you know how many people they pray? Even that you say, I do. Do you think it's easy to say that? Do you think that I do is easy to say? Say. It's not that easy. Hallelujah. Because if it's easy, why do I need to ask you a question? Yeah, you just come and we do it now. You know why we do it. That's all. But when I say, will you, is I'm asking you something. And how many people have you seen disappointed? They've been okay. Everything's so good. They're planning together. But that day, they say, will you, front of the pastor, say, Pastor, I need to go to think again. And you are thinking that the person is crazy. There are someone somewhere who is praying, is turning his tongue. She wanted to say, I do. But even the moment she said, I want to think again, she, for her, she knows that she said, I do. But the word comes, I need to think again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
While you are here, there are people who are negotiating for you to leave that shop. While you are here, there are people who are gossiping left and right. They are speaking in the evil way so that you've been kicked out or sacked. Hallelujah. So you should not take things for granted because I say I'm a Christian and now weapon forms against me shall be able to post that. Stupid. Hallelujah. Yes, you should do something better. Say to your neighbor, do something better. You must open your korokoro eyes like this. Yes, you don't play. You are opening it like this. You see, if you don't open your eyes, someone will come and snatch your husband as you are there. I'm telling you, you don't play with life, oh. Yes, if you are playing, people will come and play in your house. You cannot allow someone to come and no, it's fire for fire. If you come by fire, you find fire. Yes. The Bible said when Samuel was going to the house of Jesse, the moment he entered in town, people they ask him, do you come in peace? He said, yes, I come in peace. That means if he did not come in peace, they were ready for fire. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes. That's why I like Nigeria. When they talk, they open the eyes. Yeah, that shows you that fire is there. If you are playing, they fire you. Yes. Hallelujah. They are things that I talk, I put my eyes small. That means I'm trying to get something from you. I put my eyes small. But when I know you want to get something from me, I open my eyes like this. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You need to know what to do. Tell your neighbor, do it better. Someone somewhere is looking for your downfall. How can you sleep? I told you last time, I said, the Bible says God cannot sleep, neither slumber. If God cannot sleep, neither slumber, why are you sleeping? If God cannot sleep, neither slumber, why are you sleeping? God himself, who is the supreme God, is even not refusing to sleep because he knows the implication. But you attempt to sleep and you are not even sleeping good, you are sleeping bad. You are attracting demons and calling them by the way you. Shout fire! Shout fire! The fire! Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey. While Job was innocent, enjoying his life, someone somewhere is negotiating to take away his property, to take away his kids, to take away his feeling, to take away his wife, to take away what belonged to him. Hallelujah. That is what I was saying to you in the beginning. Any moment you see something evil happen to you, that shows that someone he wants to enjoy your peace. What devil wanted? He wanted to enjoy the happiness of devil. When he was, see what God said to him. Why are you like this? I can see from your countenance. Do you see? God can perceive that Satan was angry. He said, I can see from your countenance. So, that means he was angry against Job. What did Job do to him? Nothing. Just because Job was wealthy. So, any moment things are going fine for you, devil is angry. If you see people around you always get angry when things are working for you, you don't need to even pray for them. Just take, be careful, just take spiritual fire, package of fire, fire them. I'm not asking you to go to take water. and throw on them. If the police come to catch you, I'll tell them, I say it's your spiritual fire. So you are not allowing the enemy to enjoy what belongs to you. Because there are some people, you see, devil is a spirit. And devil, you cannot see him. You see devil on people. Some people, since you started praying, they are calling you a witch. Why are they calling you a witch? They are calling you a witch because when you pray, you disturb them. That means you must pray more. Hallelujah. So when you are praying, they are feeling piri piri, fire, fire. It's burning them. That's why they are not happy. So you need to do it even more. If you see people, they see you with a car. Your daughter is married. Your son is married. Oh, you yourself, you're getting married. They start back, 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 back. You need to know that these people, they are used by devil. They are envy of what God is doing to your life. That's why right this minute, we are going to pray for such people. How can my destiny be negotiated while I'm here? I'm innocent. I don't know what's happening. But someone, somehow, is planning evil for me. Some people, they're even saying that, tomorrow by 8, they should just die. Some are even saying, tomorrow, this appointment, they are talking all sorts of, if you have a plan tomorrow, the plan that you want, you have tomorrow. There are people who are planning against that plan. Rest this minute. Hallelujah. Maybe there is a gentleman who is following you, is ready tomorrow to propose you. Tonight is in trouble. They are tormenting him so that he does not even say that word. You know, they are very stubborn man. They are very, tonight we are going to pray. Because there are some men, they are very stubborn. But we are going to pray, God is going to touch them so that they will become sweet to you. It's not only men, even women. There are some women are boxer. They are very dangerous ones. Yeah, we're going to pray. We are going to pray. And the Lord is going to make a way. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Job's life was negotiated. And what was happening? They sent the fire in his destiny. And things begin to go bad. Things that are going bad in your life, you need to know that it is not because of what you have done. No. It is because someone accused you somewhere to a juju. To a sangoma. Somewhere, somehow, they are doing that to you. So tonight, you need to stand up. And you are going to send the fire. Say, whosoever was sending these things to me, tonight, I'm sending that back to them. Whosoever was trying to negotiate my health so that I can be sick, tonight, I'm trying by the grace of God to claim my own back. Anyone who is sitting now doing juju for me to die tomorrow, before that tomorrow appears, they must die. Every coffin that they are preparing for you, we are going to size it up. Yes. Every coffin they size for you, we are going to size it up. It will not fit you anymore, but it will be not on their on their size. You know the people of this world are very bad. You know what was happened to Jesus when Jesus died? They buried Jesus. After they buried Jesus, what did they do? Aha! They put what? They put stone. After they put stone, what did they do? They put guards. Chai! There are people as you are here. As you are here. You don't know. But you are walking with a big stone. They put a chain here. And the big stone is there. You are trying to go. You are like this. That's why you see everything you do. A and every office you are about to enter, you see people are standing there complicating you for nothing. Those are guards. So their intention was, if Jesus is trying to resurrect, they was if he was trying to raise, then the stone you put him back. Boom. Boom. That was their intention. That he could not raise. And the second they said, okay, if he's trying to force and remove the stone, the guards, they'll pick him and put him back. That is their intention.
Anybody that are prepared to put you back, right this minute, they will die by fire. I said they will die by fire. Every guard they put around your life, right now.
They want you to die. And they don't want you to see life. Listen, we are going to pray.
Say, my father, my father. Say, my father, my father. My father, my father. Hear my prayer. Hear my prayer. Anyway, that my destiny has been negotiated. Anyway, that anyone are looking for my death. Anyway, that they're negotiating my marriage. They're negotiating my health. Father! Father! Send the fire to scatter them wherever they are. Wherever they are. Wherever they are. In the name of Jesus. Shout after me, fire! 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 Scatter them now! 1, 2, 3, four, scatter them, scatter them, scatter them, scatter them, scatter them, scatter them, scatter them. Prayer, prayer, prayer. Ra, 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 ra. Prayer, 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 prayer. Prayer, 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 prayer. Prayer, prayer, prayer. Prayer, 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 prayer. Prayer, prayer, prayer. Hey, prayer, prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer, prayer. Prayer, 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 prayer. Hey, Brakoba say, Maka, Maka di Bocha. Prayer, prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer, prayer. Prayer, 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 prayer. Prayer, prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer, prayer. prayer, prayer, prayer. Prayer, 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 prayer. Now listen to me. It's not over yet. Listen to me, listen to me. That guards, that stone that they put on your neck, they put on your leg so that you cannot go forward. The people they put there to stop you, the security and the guards that they put in the offices to complicate your case, those who are speaking, they are putting you back where you are coming from. You don't need anything. You need the mighty fire to scatter that stone. And you need the confusion spirit to everybody who's standing in your case. Shut fire! Set fire. Fire! Say, oh Lord! Oh Lord! Oh Lord. Scatter! Scatter! Every stone that is in my leg, that is in my neck, let it be broken now by fire! Say, oh God! Send the fire like thunder to confuse every guard that they put there to block me. Let them receive fire. Let them receive fire. Let them receive fire. 1, 2, 3, pray. 1, 2, 3, pray, 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 pray. Prayer, 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 prayer. Send the confusion. Send. Send confusion. 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 Confusion. Send confusion. Send confusion. Prayer. 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 Prayer, prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer. Prayer, 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 prayer. Prayer, prayer. Prayer, prayer.
I want you to take an offering. Take an offering. Run in the into here, because the type of prayer you are praying is not an easy one. Someone is negotiating. When someone is negotiating, what did they normally do? When someone is negotiating, they normally trying to corrupt so that they get what they are looking for. The prayer you have made here, I want you to run whatever it is. It might be 50 rand or whatsoever. Come and draw and seal your prayer here. Run quick, run quick. Run quick. Drop it here quick. Drop it quick, drop it.
Sit down.
Sit down. Sit down.
Holy Spirit. See, I see devil negotiating something bad for someone's life. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Stand up. You sit down. You stand up. Thank you, Holy Spirit. The Lord is going to locate your story. I say, the Lord is going to locate your story today. Whosoever was looking for your head, they will die. The Spirit of God is here. You are twin. You must be Basile. I'm looking to search from the Father in the Spirit. I'm seeing something about, I don't know how to pronounce that, Maniwe or Manwin, something like that. Yes. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You see, the enemy has been looking for a family for long. And today, your struggle is ending today. Listen for me. You see, there's been this battle. As I'm talking with you right now, I'm traveling to a village, to a place. I see what was happening to your family and what is happening even now. You see, this year, there was a dead warrant that has been released in their family. And the enemy declared that in your family, within the space of 2 years, they declared that 3 people, they will die. Now, what was happening is that they did it and they shine it in your family. And you are not from here, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm seeing you from eastern part. From eastern part. And I'm traveling. There's a kind of village. I'm seeing the house. It's really not in good condition. But I'm seeing a lot of, oh my God. The plan, and I see recently they were supposed to be 3. Recently you lose 2 people.
And
thank you, Jesus. You lose man and woman. Thank you, Jesus. And the Spirit of God is saying to me, the last target they was looking. I hear the name. They are giving me a name right now. You see, there are too many ceremonies, too much ritual, and you guys is thank God because the Lord has brought you far. You are here. If it's not for God, my God. If it's not for God, there is another target that they were preparing. I hear and I see the tall guy is there. He was already the next level, and I see there are 2 names they were targeting. Is Masibu Yel is something like that. And I'm hearing Candy. Calm down. Calm down. Thank you, Jesus. And I see a young man with a light complexion. And I see with him, I see him like with a glass. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Stand. Stand on your feet. Quiet. Quiet. Kneel down.
Now, can you see how angry they are in the spirit? You can see how angry they are in the spirit. So I want you to be as more as them. Because right now we are about to terminate and we are about to consume every evil spirit.
Listen for me.
Why God has to reveal? God revealed things to empower us to stop it. If God wanted to allow it to happen, he wouldn't show us. But if God show us, that means he give us the ability to cancel it. Now, we are not only going to cancel it, because if we just cancel it, they will try again. We are going to cancel it and kill them. We are going to cancel it and what?
Kill them.
I want us to fight as if you got a weapon on you. We are going to enter into that western place around Queenstown. Queenstown, I'm seeing Queenstown. Yes. Yes, I like that spirit. May you get more angry like that. The way you are fighting for them, so God fight for you.
Can we stand fire? Can we stand fire? Can we stand fire? Fire, 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 fire. Scatter. Scatter, 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 fire, fire. Fire, 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 fire. Fire! 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 Fire!